The Trump administration, they're really all about lies, whether it's Ukraine or something else. In fact, on the topic of abortion, we're discovering that there's just this mind-boggling stream of misinformation and outright lies coming out of Fox News, being echoed by Republican politicians in the White House constantly all around the country, and then being picked up by CNN and MSNBC. Let's get a handle on the dimensions of this piece of this giant misinformation campaign. On the line with us is Sharon Kahn. She is the director of the Abortion Rights and Reproductive Health Program over at MediaMatters.org. And Media Matters, as you know, if you listen to this program regularly, I'm frequently suggesting that you read MediaMatters.org. And when anybody ever calls me with Fox News talking points, I always tell them, get over to MediaMatters.org, check this out. Sharon, welcome to the program.
Thanks so much for having me.
So tell us about what are the lies or misinformation or phrases that tend to mislead or however you would characterize them that Fox News is dropping into our media pond, and which of them are being picked up by CNN, MSNBC, and other outlets and recycled in ways that are ultimately destructive to women's reproductive rights?
Yeah, I mean, I think that you sort of pointed out the overall top line of the study we just released, which is that, you know, Fox News is dominating the conversation about abortion. And unfortunately, the talking points are making their way to lots of different places, including CNN and MSNBC at times. Our study looked at a couple of different types of misinformation, but I think the most significant one that we saw this year was misinformation about different types of abortion procedures or access to abortion. This spiked especially around the beginning of this year, 2019, around state measures to protect or to codify abortion access in New York and Virginia, where we saw, you know, lots of sensationalized talking points about infanticide or about abortion later in pregnancy that then got taken up not just in the State of the Union by Donald Trump, but also when they were talked about on networks like CNN and MSNBC, people didn't hear the other side as much as I think they needed to debunk that harmful, stigmatizing misinformation.
So the Republican, I mean, Donald Trump did this at one of his rallies. He was talking about how the Democrats, the baby is born and he's sitting there on the table and the parents are having a conversation with the doctor about whether we should kill this baby, and they decide to kill the baby. It was right out there in front of the whole world. Where did that story come from? How did that become lore? And to what extent is that actually believed by Republicans that their fellow human beings could behave that way?
Yeah, I think, I don't know that I can speak to the extent that it's believed. I think that what our data has showed us is that the talking point has been incredibly dominant on Fox News. And I think if we look at sort of the granular level of the data, we can see that conversations about abortion in January, in particular about these laws in New York and Virginia, spiked on Fox before the State of the Union. In fact, there was almost 6.5 hours of coverage about the exact types of misinformation you were just describing, which we know are sensationalized and inaccurate. Right. And then those talking points showed up in the State of the Union themselves.
Didn't what started this, or at least this is when I first became aware of it, was Ralph Northam, who is the governor of Virginia, who was a physician. In fact, I think he was an obstetrician. And he was talking about what happens when a woman gives birth to a child who is literally dying. The child has such severe birth defects that there's no way to save its life. It's going to be dead within a matter of hours. And, you know, he said basically what we try to do is make the child as comfortable as possible. And that got twisted into, we sit around and decide whether we're going to kill this kid or how quickly. And then that got twisted into, this is a common conversation that doctors have with women who are pregnant. Am I remembering that right?
So it's interesting. It actually goes a little bit before that. I think, so this is actually something that we noticed when we pulled all the data for this study, which is that the conversations about later abortion, especially the sort of sensationalized and inaccurate types of conversations about it, right, actually began on Fox News at the end of January before Virginia's bill and Northam's subsequent comments ever happened. Mm-hmm. Fox News was talking about abortion and later abortions for almost a week before any of that happened. And I think when the Virginia bill was proposed is when we really saw that take off. And ultimately, that's when we saw talking points show up from Fox News, not just in political conversations, but also in CNN and MSNBC's coverage as well.
For example?
For an example of the statement?
Yeah.
I mean,
how do MSNBC and CNN, you know, serve as an echo chamber when they I'm guessing they don't intend to?
Right. I think a really good example of that would be once the conversation shifted to a political one about later abortion, there would be examples of segments on CNN and MSNBC where they would say, you know, conservatives are very angry about allegations of infanticide, period. There would never be an additional statement saying, and that's an inaccurate representation of later abortion, or here are the statistics about how later abortion is, or the context on those comments.
That's a lie? I mean, it's against the law to kill children. Infanticide is killing babies. It's literally against the law. It doesn't happen.
Right. I mean, I think that's another good example of what happens when abortion is only discussed as a question of politics or optics and not as a question of health care.
Right. It's truly remarkable. So I'm assuming that what you're trying to do, we're talking with Sharon Kahn with MediaMatters.org. I'm assuming that what you're trying to do is not just push back on the lies that regularly come out of Fox News. I mean, we kind of expect that. But also to sensitize CNN and MSNBC to the way that they're being exploited by Fox News. Any indication, A, is that one of your goals? And B, whether it is or isn't, any indication that that might be succeeding, that you might be having some impact in that regard?
Yeah, I think that it is important for networks that, I mean, part of the problem is that Fox is so loud in this conversation. And so when CNN and MSNBC are having conversations about abortion, oftentimes the terms have already been set before the stories even get to those networks. So I think that is sort of a framework, is something that's important to us to make sure that reporters, viewers, everyone understands. The second thing is to make sure that when reporting on abortion-related issues, people are providing adequate context, whether that's calling out a lie for a lie or whether that's making sure that there are enough statistics or information to make sure that people are getting a holistic picture of what abortion access is like and not just the sensationalized right-wing media talking point.